out of you and me, flowing out into the desert, setting all the captives free.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dear brothers and sisters, we are on Thursday within the octave of Easter. Today, Jesus appeared to the disciples and showed them the signs, the wounds that he bare, and he wished them peace. So in the peace of Christ, let us join our prayers together and pray and celebrate the Holy Eucharist offered to the Father. Now let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
On earth, peace to people.
Let us pray. O God, who have united the many nations in confessing your name, grant that those reborn in the font of baptism may be one in the faith of their heart and the homage of their deeds. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
So today we offer this Mass pray for Aurelio Valencia, Father John Kelly, Nelson, Liz, Annette Costa, Kristen Weston, Ruth Oliveira, Jose Ernest, and Eduardo Lima, Marie-Jane Joini, Lovigida Ortiz, and the intentions of Jaden Lee.
Lectura del libro de los Hechos de los Apóstoles. Como el paralítico curado por Pedro y Juan, no se les despegaba, todo el pueblo asombrado corrió hacia ellos al pórtico de Salomón, y al ver a la muchedumbre, Pedro les dirigió la palabra: Israelitas, ¿por qué les causa admiración esto y por qué nos miran de ese modo? Como si por nuestro poder o nuestra virtud hubiéramos hecho andar a este hombre. El Dios de Abraham, de Isaac y de Jacob, el Dios de nuestros padres, ha glorificado a su siervo Jesús, a quien ustedes entregaron a Pilato y a quien rechazaron de su presencia, cuando él ya había decidido ponerlo en libertad. Rechazaron al santo, al justo, y pidieron el indulto de un asesino. Han dado muerte al autor de la vida, pero Dios lo resucitó de entre los muertos, y de ello nosotros somos testigos. El nombre de Jesús y la fe en él es lo que ha robustecido los miembros de este hombre, al que están viendo y todos conocen. Esta fe es la que le ha restituido completamente la salud, como pueden observar. Ahora bien, hermanos, yo sé que ustedes han obrado por ignorancia, de la misma manera que sus jefes, pero Dios cumplió así lo que había predicho por boca de los profetas, que su Mesías tenía que padecer. Por lo tanto, arrepiéntase y conviértase, para que se les perdonen sus pecados y el Señor les mande el tiempo de la consolación y les envíe de nuevo a Jesús, el Mesías, que les estaba destinado. Aunque Él tiene que quedarse en el cielo hasta la restauración universal de la que habló Dios por boca de su profeta desde muy antiguo, en efecto, Moisés dijo: el Señor Dios hará surgir de entre sus hermanos un profeta como yo. Escuchen todo cuanto les diga. Quien no escuche al profeta será expulsado del pueblo. Y todos los profetas, a partir de Samuel, anunciaron igualmente estos días. Ustedes son herederos de los profetas y beneficiarios de la alianza que Dios hizo con sus padres, cuando le dijo a Abraham: tu descendencia será fuente de bendición para toda la humanidad. Para ustedes, en primer lugar, ha resucitado Dios a su siervo y lo ha enviado para bendecirlos y ayudarlos a que cada uno se aparte de sus iniquidades. Palabra de Dios. Te alabamos, Señor.
behold your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars which you set in place. What is man that you should be mindful of him, or the son of man that you should care for him?
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The disciples of Jesus recounted what had taken place along the way and how they had come to recognize him in the breaking of bread. While they were still speaking about this, he stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." But they were startled and terrified and thought that they were seeing a ghost. Then he said to them, "Why are you troubled? And why do you question arise in your hearts? Look at my hands and my feet, that it is I myself. Touch me and see, because a ghost does not have flesh and bones. As you can see, I have." And as he said this, he showed them his hands and his feet. While they were still incredulous for joy, were amazed, he asked them, "Have you anything here to eat?" They gave him a piece of baked fish. He took it, ate it in front of them. He said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses and in the prophets and Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures. And he said to them, "Thus it is written that the Christ would suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance for the forgiveness of sins would be preached in his name to all the nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things." The Gospel of the Lord.
My dear brothers and sisters, Jesus was raised from the dead
and today appeared to his disciples, and the gift that he gave them was, peace be with you. Peace be with you. So that's what he said to his disciples. And they all were fear, and they thought that's a ghost. Because Jesus, in the first fruit, who was raised from the dead. So the peace that Jesus gave them strengthened them and give them courage to go out, to preach the good news, to cure the sick, as we heard in the first reading. Peter and John came into the temple, yet he cured a cripple. Yet the peace of Jesus expressed not only to the disciples, but to all of us who are cannot be here in the church, yet at home. The peace of Jesus that expressed to those who may lose their loved one, their parents in this coronavirus, or for the parents who lost their children in this coronavirus. Because yes, Jesus, the resurrection one, that will rise from the dead, that he promised that those who believe in him also will be resurrected with him. So therefore, with that peace, we entrust our loved ones who have passed away because of the coronavirus into the hands of God. And because of this peace, we can renew our hope and our life in this resurrection, Jesus. And yet, we also have the courage to live, to share the space in our home during these times with those around us. We have to learn to be coexist with those that we may not want to talk. So this peace of Jesus, we cannot just keep it for ourselves. It's the different peace, the peace that gives us the courage to share with other people. So I wish you at home the peace of the resurrected Jesus always with you. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Food of the earth and workable hands, you become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Food of the vine and workable hands, you become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may become acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice. Praise the Lord in his name, for the good and the good of his holy church.
Graciously be pleased, O Lord, to accept the sacrificial gifts we offer joyfully, both for those who have been reborn and in hope of your increased help from heaven, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to lord you yet more graciously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restore our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people, exult in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending out your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat his bread and drink his love, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memory of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and Myron Cotta our Bishop, and all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, especially Uriel, Valencia, Father John Kelly, Nelson, Liz, Annette Costa, Christine Weston, Ruth Alveira, Jose Inez, Eduardo Lima, Marigiani Trojani, Liovegidi Ortiz. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from the distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, may peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Behold, the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lord.
Lord, I am not worthy you should enter my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. Hear, O Lord, our prayer that this most holy exchange by which you have redeemed us may bring your help in this present life and ensure for us eternal gladness. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
San Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle.
Your defense against the wickedness and snare of the devil.
May God rebuke him, we humbly pray, and do thou so please the heavenly host. By the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the root souls. Amen. Most Sacred Heart of Jesus,
have mercy.
Immaculate Heart of Mary,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Bernard,
pray for us.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace. The Mass is ended. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.
Right after the Mass, we have adorations, so please join us.
The earth.